tradition always sings the beautiful grace of God. The old and traditional hymn they sing. Amazing grace, how sweet that sounds, that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Yes, the blinded people can today say, though I am a blind man, still I can live on, I can see on. That is called the grace of God. My dear friends, today you and I are alive. At least I can tell you strongly that I am alive and my community is alive. It's because of the grace of God. The sickness is all around, but it has not come into your house. Do you know why? Do you know? Open your eyes and see. It is the grace of God. If the sickness God would have allowed, it would have easily reached you. The Queen of Spain, she was killed with corona. The Prime Minister of England, he was affected by corona. Yes. The Canadian President's wife, she got into corona. They are all rich people, highly influenced people. They are highly advanced countries, big people. They are all dying, not you and me. Today, God has kept us safe because our God is a living God, and it is because of His grace of God. That's why St. Paul says, today what I am, it is by the grace of God. Grace of God is more than the mercy of God. Mercy means when a man is in a despair situation, he or she calls upon the Lord. And the Lord hears their cry and He helps them out. But there is a situation where man doesn't deserve. He doesn't deserve. Knowing it is wrong, they do it. But even then, the grace of God comes to be with them, which our human mind cannot understand. The grace of God doesn't mean that He supplies what we want, but the grace of God is God walking with man in spite of man not walking with God. God giving Himself to man even in the moment man doesn't understand or walk with God. We read in the Old Testament, people are going and telling Peter, going and telling Moses, see, we are all dying with hunger and thirst. Give us water. Moses was upset. Moses was angry. And he went to the Lord and said, Lord, look, these people are abusing me. The Lord speaks. When you are tensed, when you are depressed, when you are angry, you will not know what the another speaks. Because your mind gets agitated. And you want to prove that you are the right, others are wrong. This tendency comes into our lives. Peter was so upset. And he was so angry. He said to the Lord, Lord, look at these people. The Lord is speaking, but Moses can't hear properly. And when God says, my son, take the staff, which is the symbol of my presence, and you have already hit, it has become very old, it has become weak. The Lord says, you take my staff, go to the rock. Now, speak to the rock. A word from your mouth
who represents me is enough. Speak to the rock, water will come. Moses was upset and angry with the people, and he did not listen to God. What a great tragedy. Most of the time, we don't listen to others. Then in between, we scratch our head. Oh, what did my mummy told me? It's like once I went to the, my mother asked me to go and bring some jalebis. And I went off of the market, and afterwards I did not know for what my mother sent me. Then I saw my auntie coming, and my auntie was asking for to go to somewhere else to take the things. I went along with her. Here the guests have come, jalebi has to be served, I did not come. Sometimes it happens like that. So when I came in the evening, I got nice beatings that day. In life, we are in our own absent-mindedness. They call absent-mind professors. And we are in our own little world. And that's what happened to Moses. He did not hear properly. Now he goes and takes the, he took the staff, he heard staff, rock, water, that's all. So he went, took the staff, and he, like earlier time, he hit the staff. God might have been very sad because the staff would have been broken and there was no water. Because that was not the thing God told him. So the people who came along with Moses, they got opportunity, they began to laugh. Moses was so angry. Maybe he was sweating. He took the staff. Again he hit. Maybe first time he hit and angry on the people. Now maybe he is hitting of his anger on God. But God, though he did not tell Moses that you hit and I will give you water, but he is hitting and the people are laughing at Moses. God cannot bear to see his own chosen one is being humiliated. So God forgets about his pride, what he has spoken, and he brings the water when Moses hit the second time and honors Moses in front of the people. This is what we call the grace of God. Do you know, we are under the grace of God. You and I are alive because of the grace of God. We don't have corona. Why? It's grace of God. We have to celebrate it every minute. For example, if we see our house, we have got our children, HIV/AIDS infected children, they are easy to prone to get the sickness because their immune system is very poor. We have got so many elderly people, more than 10 people with me. What happened? But we are all safe. It's just because of the grace of God. The moment we recognize, Lord, what we don't deserve, we receive from you, Lord. The way you protect us, Lord, thank you, Lord. This sensitivity, God wants us to have it. Even when man is not sensitive, the grace of God shows God is sensitive. God never asks whether it is right or wrong. What Moses, what have you done? Is it right or wrong? He never asks. He sees my son has to be protected. My son has to be honored. That's all. Love consumes all the dirt to himself, to oneself, and protects the another. And that is the grace of God. And we, you and I are under the grace of God. This is what Jesus said to Paul when he was going through pain in 2 Corinthians chapter 12 verse 9. My grace is sufficient for you. In your weakness cannot overcome you, because my grace will take control of you.